All right, what's up, guys? What am I doing? What's up, guys? So today I want to go over my new favorite piano sample library that I've ever owned. And it's quite possibly top three all-time favorite just virtual instruments or plugins that I've owned. And you already know what it is because you clicked on it, but Keyscape is freaking sweet. And that's an understatement. It is incredible. I, you know, for 3-4 years heard about Keyscape. I was like, it looks cool. I'm not going to spend $400 on a piano library. I'll just keep using what I was using, which was things like Maverick, Art Vista, the Midnight Grand Piano, the Noir stuff. I used Art Vista a lot, actually, which I still like that piano. But I said, hey, what I have is fine, so there's no reason why I'm going to just buy another piano library. And that will go down as one of my biggest regrets in my life, is not buying Keyscape back when I heard about it a few years ago. And so hopefully this video, if you're like kind of on the edge of like, hey, it's an expensive library, hopefully this video will help you kind of get over that, just get over that point. Or maybe not. Maybe you just end up not liking Keyscape. I don't know how that's possible. But I freaking love Keyscape. I will say about Keyscape, it is extremely large. There are a lot of sounds, a lot of different things to, a lot of different presets to pull up. It's also pretty taxing on your computer. We might get to experience that here just as I'm going through preset after preset after preset. Sometimes it takes a second for it to load in. They are big files. So, if you have a computer that's not as amazing as someone else's computer, then, you know, maybe look into the specs of Keyscape and just make sure you can handle, your computer can handle Keyscape. But, so this is, I'm going to try and go through as many of these as I can. There are a ton. I don't know exactly how many there are, but there are quite a bit. I'll probably breeze through some of these later ones just because they're more nuanced. But I want to go through at least some of the core ones, like the LAC7, some of the uprights, the Rhodes sound fantastic. If this is the kind of content that you guys like to see, feel free to like and subscribe. It helps the YouTube algorithm and also just helps me know that this is the kind of stuff you want to see. Leave a comment below telling me what you liked or didn't like about the video, and if you want to just see more of this kind of stuff. So let's dive right on in. So I've got Keyscape open here, Keyscape Library. The C7 Grand Piano is kind of the, I don't want to say the main piano, but just so you know, I have nothing on these. I don't have any reverb on it. Maybe I could throw just a tiny, tiny, tiny reverb on, just because you'll probably have something like this on. Yeah, that's very subtle. So, yeah, C7, this piano, if this is the only thing that came with Keyscape, I think it'd be worth it. Sounds so good. I'll go through some of these parameters down here, they don't change a ton. They do change a little bit when you kind of get a, when you change the modeled instrument. Reverb. The thing with reverbs, most of the time, I'm not using the reverb that's baked into the piano. I'll leave this on here. I wouldn't turn this off, but I'm not really relying on reverbs that come with these sample libraries, just because I own probably better reverbs. If you another plug, if you don't own Valhalla, that's worth getting too. That's another plugin I sat on for a while and I regret it. EQ settings, bare bones. There are some denoising settings on some of these pianos. It comes with a lot of noise in it to make it sound more natural. You might want to get rid of that. Compression, again, a lot of these settings are kind of just baked in that don't need a lot of tweaking. And if you're going for something other than what this preset's providing, you're probably going to go to outside compressors or outside EQs or different reverbs. So yeah, I don't tweak a ton of this stuff. So I've tweaked some of this before, just the feel, you know, like a gentle, I mean, you're not going to be able to know because you're not touching it, but it changes the velocity response a little bit. All right, let's move on to the next piano. I'd love that one. I use this one all the time, the LA C7 Grand. So I love that one. All right, rock. Nice and bright, cinematic. Freaking beautiful. I love that. Unreal Smash. I've never used this one. You kind of get the vibe, you know. Never use that one, but it has its purpose. Softest. This is one of my favorite presets in this whole library. So pretty. Bright. It's actually pretty nice. That's nice. I actually should use that one more. It's a good one. Just what you and me. So good. Pop. So good. Oops. That's not what I want. Wash. What is it? I forgot what this one is. Oh, yeah. Kind of like the cinematic one. I should use this one more. That's gorgeous. I love all that reverb. Indie. Nice classical You might want to turn that pedal noise off. That would drive some front of house engineers crazy. It's nice. That one's pretty down, straightforward. Yeah, these sound so good. Every time I go through them, I'm like, sick. Dark score. That's there. Yeah, there's some like octave shifting in there. I mean, I'm just playing like even this middle C, you can hear the da, but also the da. Woof. Nice. Thank you. question is. Yeah, this my computer was taking a little bit to load that one up, so I was popping. Are you even a piano player if you haven't played that 1,000 times on a gig? This is cool. I tried to use this actually the other day. It's this. Where's the saturation on this thing? It's like cranked up. Was it on this page? Oh, it was the tape. Yeah, here. It's nice. All right, so that's the LAC7. Like I said, if that if Keyscape just came with those, you know, 20 pianos, sick. But it also comes with some sick sounding Rhodes. I mean, these sound. Sorry, I'm not always representing these instruments well by just noodling, but they just sound so good, like to sit in front of these. Oof. Song in a while. Thank you. Yeah, these sound great. That's not what kind of song you play that on, but... that one, but whatever. These have unit. All right, claves. Gotta have a good selection of claves, you know. Experience playing too many claves, to be honest. Sound good though. Yeah, it's like a guitar pickup, having the different pickup options. Basically, it's like a guitar, it feels like. Yeah, so I mean, there's a lot of good clav options in here. I don't want to. Sounds cool. Yeah, I mean, these are turning into just leads. Which is cool. I'm afraid some like actual legit clav guys out there watching this going, no, that's not how you play clav. Yeah, so those sound cool. Like I said, I'm not a huge clav guy. I don't use it a ton, but they sound awesome. So wing upright. A little upright action. So good. My stride piano is a little weak these days. That's kind of cool. In very specific use, but Celeste, or as I said, Celeste for a long time. The first note. Yeah, I mean, these are pretty straightforward. Just when I remember going through these, I mean, they sound like a Celeste, modeled well. Scoring stay. Yeah, I mean, these all sound. Not the right usage. Yeah, sick. That'd actually be cool if you like threw a big fat verb on it. Isn't that maple? What is that? I forgot. Yeah, I mean, just verbed out. Cool, you know, again, very nuanced usage, but some of those are actually pretty sick. All right, Rhodes. Just, man. What song it is, drop it in the comments. I forgot how that song goes. Dang, I just embarrassed myself. Yeah, these all just sound just freaking great. Thank you. attached to it. I like that. I like that one. I mean, there's just so many in here. Like, I want to get this to an hour, and there's just so many things I haven't touched yet. I think y'all get the idea, right? I mean, this is like... I mean, it's just... Man, just... Okay, and then we got a little whirly. It's like just sick. So good. Try not to rush through these. It's just, you know, there's a lot. Yep. Have to use that on a gig, that specific one coming up. Yeah. I mean, a lot of these are like, you wouldn't use them live. They're like very nuanced in the studio. Like, you're probably not using this one live. I mean, there could be something, but... All right, so next we have duos. These are like kind of their own specially created combination. Like, they sound awesome. These are cool. Some of these are like, all right, I could do this myself. Like, I wouldn't have thought of that. Maybe I would have. That's cool because it kind of gives you the nice, like, mellow piano, but also kind of the attack of the regular C7 there. Let's see. That's cool. yeah, that's a cool sound. I'm not going to go through all these. Maybe this piano. Yeah, if you've never layered piano notes before, I mean, you can do that on your own. Kind of gives you the body of the Rhodes. Like Rhodes kind of has a fuller sound to it, but the piano has that attack. I do that a lot, at least live. It's cool. I like that. I'm not gonna go with maybe this one. Again, this is something you could create on your own if you wanted to. All right, wing tack piano. These are just more wing of the wing upright stuff. A little bit more nuanced in here, so I won't go through this. Rhodes piano bass. This is like just a, I think, an octave, two octave little thing. Specific use, but I would use these live if I had to play bass. That's pretty cool. Yeah, sick. All right, this little guy here. That's all about. I don't need to dig into those. This little dude here. Yeah, clavy. I can't speak a ton to that because I've played that maybe two times in my life. Cool. Pretty sick. Yeah, awesome. I mean, if you're buying a library just for this, that's kind of weird, but it's here if you really needed it. That's how awesome this library is. There's freaking a million things. I'm only halfway down the list. Y'all know what that's all about. Okay, so let's get to this dude. Yeah. Sick. Electric harpsichord. Okay, harmonicord here. Yeah. Maybe you're using that. Who knows? I can't speak a ton to that instrument because I never use it. Okay, here we go. Oh, yeah. I skipped over a ton. Yeah, these are modeled after some of the old sounds awesome. I mean, these just sound great. You know, there's so many different. Mm-hmm. amazing. Very nuanced usage, but very cool. Oh, the MK80. Forgot about this dude. Some more whirly action. I mean, just more whirly settings. But I think at this point, you've seen enough. Deep, you know. Get to plan it in. Just everything in here. All right, the planet T. I've actually never played one of these before, live at least, or in real life. What is this? Yeah, very nuanced usage. Could be cool. Got the toy piano. Yeah. Which everyone, I mean, yeah, this is what it is. All right, let's keep going. Vibinette. Yeah. So, yeah, I hope y'all aren't offended that I'm, like, brushing through these. Because these are a little more nuanced down here. All right. So, yeah, there's a lot of, you know, kind of cool things here in the back end. Like I said, you know, the Planet M, Planet N, Planet T, Rhodes 1946, Toy Piano, Vibinette, Vintage Vibe, Weltmeister, Electro Grand, some duo stuff. So yeah, there's a lot of kind of nuanced, cool things on the back end of this catalog, or back end of this library. You're probably not buying it for those things, but they're definitely there, just kind of like icing on the cake. They do come with a creative library, whatever that means. I'll show you a couple of those. You know, so they're kind of, they're mixing some of the Keyscape settings with some of the Omnisphere settings. I don't know if this comes if you don't have an Omnisphere. I honestly don't know. So I don't want to spend, I mean, you know, there's cool things in here. I doubt you're buying this stuff because of these settings or presets. I would never use that. I mean, these are here. Yeah. Good luck finding a way to. So, Yep, these are there. I don't know if you'd ever use these, but again, you're probably not buying this library because of these presets in the Creative library, but they are here if you want them. Just a little icing on the cake. That's a thing. So yeah, I think y'all get the vibe. So hope y'all enjoyed this video. Again, please hit the like button or the subscribe button underneath if you want to see more of this kind of content. If you have any questions or any feedback, please leave a comment below. Tell me what you hated, what you loved, or just whatever. You know, maybe you just say, "Hey Sam, I never want to see a video from you ever again." Leave that comment so I can read it and cry myself to sleep. I'm just kidding. All right, thank you all for watching, and I will see you later.